Hi, this is Bill Raymond from the Bill Talks AI newsletter. Today, I'm going to be talking about this topic called RAG, or Retrieval-Augmented Generation. I'm taking a course right now on generative AI. Generative AI, meaning a chatbot, so you've heard the names, Google's Gemini, OpenAI's ChatGPT, Microsoft's Copilot, Anthropic's Claude. Sometimes when you're chatting with these chatbots, you might want to ask about information that's your own corporate internal data, information that only you have access to because it's unique to your business. And the chatbots may not have access to that information. So therefore, you want to connect it in some way. By using RAG, you can converse with the AI. In this case, I'm going to be using Google's Gemini. You can converse with the AI and prompt it with a question. And then that prompt will be processed along with extracting data from your own data set and then provide a response in a natural language. So in this case, if you're taking the course, which is the Kaggle GenAI course, it's running between November 11th and 15th in 2024. And this is a day two course. And this is day three for me, but I was up at 4:30 a.m. working on this video and looking to show you some things. So you will be most familiar with this video if you are taking the course. But here you can see I have a Python notebook, a Kaggle notebook, that I'm going to run. And this is the code that was provided to me as part of the training course. Now, let's just kind of quickly go through what's happening. It's installing some specialty code that we're going to use. It's setting up an API key, which is kind of like a way for my notebook that I'm running right now, the code that I'm running to talk to Google Gemini. And then it does a number of other things, but here is where we pretend like we're this company that has secret data that we want a user to be able to chat about. Let's say it's our corporate website, and it's the owner's manual for our car. So the owner's manual is broken up into three separate documents. One is a document about operating the climate control system. Another is operating the touchscreen. And finally, there's another one about operating the shift gears. So these are three documents. They could be Word, PDF, text, any number of different types of formats. In this case, it's just text, but you can just imagine that you could upload all of this information. And again, the customer may not have access to these documents, but you do. So what you do is you take these documents and you put them into a special database. In this case, we're using a database called ChromaDB. It's doing these things called vectorizing and embedding. It's trying to find all the words so they kind of match up and combine in ways that are easily found in a natural language search. And then it's also embedding it so that it puts that data into something that's more readable by AI. And so it goes and does all of that, and you can see that in the database, there's three rows. If I were to show a little bit of that database, you can see what I mean by that whole vectorization and embedding. This is actually what the database looks like. So all that text I showed you about operating the touchscreen and the shift controls, that's what it looks like to the AI. Okay, so we're going to just hide that. We're not going to get into that detail in this video. Now you can see that in this code, we're going to do a prompt. We're going to prompt Google's Gemini. How do you use a touchscreen to play music? Now, Google Gemini doesn't know what on earth you're talking about because it needs that document. So what it's going to do is create the query first. The code is going to query that database, and it's going to find a passage, a segment of that document that represents probably the best answer. So it says your Google car has a large touchscreen display, blah, blah, blah. And for example, you can touch the navigation icon to get directions. or touch the music icon to play your favorite songs. So that passage does answer the question, how do you use a touchscreen to play music? It also provides more information about using the touchscreen. So at this point, someone's typed a prompt and our code has intercepted the prompt, if you will. And it said, okay, let me go and ask this custom database that Google Gemini has no access to and get a little bit of that information. And then we're going to augment that question with a further prompt, which says you are a helpful and informative bot. You're going to provide basic answers, non-technical audience, and here's the query and here's that passage. So you could see here, this is kind of what it looks like. This is that query, that prompt that someone typed, and here's that passage, that detail that we got from our database. Now what we can do is send that entire detail to Gemini, and just imagine you're sitting at a chatbot right now. This is the response. You can play your favorite music simply touching the music icon on the touchscreen display. So you can see it took this entire detail here, your Google car has a large touchscreen display that provides access, blah, 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 and it whittled it down to this simple answer, okay? So we retrieved information, we augmented it with this additional detail, and then we generated the final response that the user sees. So here's what happened when I was using this. I thought, well, wouldn't it be cool if I could ask two questions? So let's come back up here again. And it says, how do you use the touchscreen to play music? And I might want to say also, how do I put the car into park? Okay, now I'm going to go ahead and run this again. And I'll say, run this current cell and everything after it. Notice that that query, that search, only got the first part of the question. It didn't recognize that there were two questions here. So it says your Google car has a touchscreen display. Here's how to play, but it doesn't have the answer for how to put the car into park. Let's go down and see how the final Gemini response looks. So it says a touchscreen display. This is how you press it. Press the music icon on the touchscreen. It got that right. The second part, it says the car has a built-in parking system, so you don't need to manually shift the car into park. You can use a touchscreen to access a car's features, but shifting the car into park is not one of them. That is a hallucination. That is not factual. Because if I come up here, we know that our search did not provide that information from the database. But if I go up to the documents, okay, here they are. Shifting gears in your Google car has an automatic transmission. To shift gears, simply move the shift lever. Park, this position is when you are parked. Okay, so the AI said that functionality doesn't even exist. So I wanted to solve for this problem. And that's what happened with my work that I did here in this workbook. So I took all of the underpinnings of the first workbook and made some modifications. And I'll provide a link to this workbook that you can take a look at in the description below. But you'll also notice that there's a version control here. And I have Bill's multiple query version. That's the one that I'm working with, okay? So even though it says version 14, that's the one you would want to look at. Okay, so I run the code. So to scroll back up to the top, I run the code, does all the things, installs things, sets up the Google API key, still has the documentation, still creates the information into the database. Nothing really has changed here. We still have the embeddings. You can see there's three rows. And if I peek at the data, you can see it's still that same kind of information that we had before. So nothing's really changed in the code so far. Now, here's where things change. You can see I have the original question, how do you use a touchscreen to play music? But what I did was I modified that a little bit and I created this another query, how do you use a touchscreen to play music? And then also, how do I park the car? So that's a question I showed you before. So I'm going to just go ahead and run that. Here's what is happening is when one program talks to another program, especially when they're not exactly the same program, you know, over the internet, if you will, what you might use is a format that they both understand. And in this case, it's the JSON format. And that's what I'm using throughout all of this. So JSON is just, think of that as a document that kind of describes things, almost like a little database. So you can see here, there's an open bracket and a squiggly bracket and a closed squiggly bracket. And inside of that, we have questions. And inside of that, we have another bracket, a square bracket that has two questions in it. So that's what the JSON looks like. And it can get fairly large as you go along. So the next thing that I did was I actually asked Gemini to take a look at that prompt. Okay, so take a look at this prompt. How do you use a touchscreen display? Also, how do I park the car? And I asked that to break that out into multiple questions. So now that I have all these questions, I can also search the database for the answer. Okay. And so now when I come down here, if I just take a look here, you can see, I didn't run all of the code again. So let me just go ahead and run that. Sorry. Run current and after. There we go. Okay. So now we have down here, we can see that we've broken this into two questions. Okay. I, as a software developer, have no idea how many questions were asked. Was one, two, five? I have no idea. What I did was I sent the prompt to Gemini and I said, hey, please tell me if you see one question or multiple, and for each one of those, put them into their own question. And then when you give me those questions back, I'm going to search the database and provide an answer. Okay, so now that we have those answers, I've listed out all of the detail here just so you can see more information. But now what you can see is at the end, it says you can play your favorite music with the touchscreen display using your Google car. Simply touch the music icon. That's exactly what we got before. To park your car, move the shift lever to the park position. This will lock the wheels and prevent the car from moving. There. Now we have two real answers. We don't have a hallucination, and we can go back and check those documents and see that that information really does exist. This way, I now can parse out multiple questions using Gemini, let Gemini figure out how many questions there are, have Gemini come back with the prompts, and then I can re-prompt with those questions along with providing answers from the database. I hope this was helpful to you. I will use this moment to just let you know that I do also run not only the Bill Talks AI newsletter, but I do run regular training sessions. And there's a QR code here if you want to see when my next training session is up. And I will teach you how to do some of these more advanced prompting techniques without code, using any of the powerful AI chatbots that are out there. I hope this is useful to you. And if I learn more on day 3, I'll create another video.